Ladies and gentlemen, I'm the Lumberjack, and at the end of the last Thomas Wade video, I did the Harry Doyle thing. Well, I will play the audio for you. Here it is. Come on.
And so we got one goddamn hit.
You can't say goddamn on the air.
Don't worry, nobody's listening anyway.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That is the line that I was quoting at the end of the last Thomas Wade episode. Let's see. We got Arizona. No, we're going to sim all of that. Okay, let's see. 916 points. How many would I need? Oh! I'm at a point where upgrading the power is like ridiculously prohibitively expensive. Alright, I'm not going to worry about it too much then. I don't get that. Is it saying that I didn't bat in any of those games? Well, whatever. Alright, next appearance against San Francisco. What?
I'm going to do another video on
Alright, here we go.
Thomas Wade will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first.
Alright. I just want to zoom out a little bit and then zoom in.
First pitch coming.
Alright, there we go.
Swing and a ball sliced foul into the seats down the left.
Oh, hey! Are my sliders loaded? Yes, they are. Okay, good. Woo!
Ball one.
Yeah, I'm not an idiot. I ain't gonna swing at that. Let me turn the TV down a little bit here, too.
Swing and a miss. One and two.
Wow. No chance of getting on top of that fastball. I mean,
why? Why?
1-2. Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed, so he'll need to get the force at first. But the recovery throw will be in time to first. Thomas Wade will try it again. Set down on strikes his first time. Now a ball hit pretty well to the left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. And this is going to be a foul ball.
All right, come on now, one time,
let's fly.
Hey, you got it.
Go with ball bounced back up the middle. And the throw on by Scudero's in time for number one.
Well, if you're going to make an out, you have to make a productive out. And that moves a man up to third now, which is one away.
I don't care about making productive outs. I care about getting hits. And right now, I'm not getting any.
Now, he's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. First pitch of the AB is swung on and lifted in the air.
Yeah, but that's going to be an easy out.
John will tuck this one away, and that ends the inning. Down in order go the Mets. And this is still a 4-1 ball game. Thomas Wade will stand in for the fourth time now. Still looking
256. Really?
He's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far. They've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. 5-1 our score as we play the eighth.
I don't care about inflicting fly balls.
Now here's a ball hit.
I care about.
Throw will get him for the second out, but meanwhile, the run is in.
Well, I guess I got an RBI in the playbook.
No sense in taking a chance trying to cut down that guy at the plate. So they'll be pretty happy just to trade the run for the out.
Well, the bats were certainly working in this one, but out of everybody, I'd say.
Mine wasn't. Never mind. 18-7, yeah. I think this month of April may be the highlight of our year.
Stand in here. He drove in one of their two runs in last night's ball game.
Yeah.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Echevarria for one, but one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
Still ain't going to be a hit.
Buster Posey will stand in now.
Oh, come on. Can I move up a little? Damn.
Francoeur is there, and he'll put it away to retire.
Okay, why was that a fielding opportunity for me? I mean, the ball was never going to go to me, right? So why was that a fielding opportunity for me?
Thomas Wade will stand in. He reached on a fielder's choice his first time. First pitch now from Lincecum. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
It looked like he was going to try to go the other way with that thing, but a wise idea there to try to hold up.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Now the 1-1 pitch. Up and in here as he had to bend out of danger.
can't imagine guys like that too much.
Too much indeed. You start getting into
Lincecum?
The danger area when it's up and in that eye.
Swing, hard hit ball to second.
Hey, look at that! I can't hit it somewhere that,
now a long throw to
that
third.
There isn't a fielder at.
And he'll make it over to third base safely, so that puts Marsh at the corners.
What I meant to say was, hey, look at that, I actually can get a base hit.
Right there. You know as a hitter that you're going to want to make sure you hit it to the right side to get that runner to third base.
Give me a sec, folks.
But if you do it well enough,
I need to go get another snack.
Check it out. He lets this pitch
The bag's empty here.
Him, but then he manages to still get good contact and send it into right field for the base hit.
Hold up, give me a minute, folks, I'm getting a snack.
Thomas Wade will dig in now. One for two to this point.
Thomas Wade. Here we go.
Now here's the first pitch. The first pitch to him here is hit on the ground to the left side as he doesn't waste any time. That's into left for a base hit. And they will hold that runner over at third as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away.
Well, these guys aren't wasting a whole lot of time up there. They've taken an aggressive approach here early in the count. It's paid off for them through the first few innings.
Joaquin Arias will dig in. He popped out his first time. On the ground towards second. Throw gets him, two down.
Yep, routine grounder.
There's our line score through the first four and a half, and these guys have basically had the bats taken right out of their hands. Just one hit to this point. Thomas Wade will step in. A base hit in his last time. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Now with two on, nobody out. You gotta be thinking, strikeout double play out there on the mound. One or the other is what you really need.
And he swings and pops it foul behind the plate. And he will make the over-the-head catch behind the plate. Wow, a nice play there.
Come on!
Thomas Wade will try again.
So they're basically saying that those games I've simmed, I didn't play in? I mean, really?
This guy, Curtis Granderson. He's our tops player.
Ah, what the heck? I got two base hits, so that's good. Alright. Tell you what, we'll finish up with that. Yeah. Ah, alright, yeah. We'll finish up with this training session. That'll be good. That'll be a good thing. Okay, I guess. I didn't go very far. Well, there you go. Now I'm in negative numbers. This is why I haven't passed this level. God, seriously, Sony. Sony, please, please allow me and everybody else who has a PlayStation 4 controller, allow us to disable the vibration. Well, at least I'm not negative numbers anymore, but there's no way I'm gonna get a bronze here. Weak hit? How is that a weak hit? Told ya! And, yeah, those three poor ones is what ruined my chances. Hey! I torpedoed myself, so I got nobody to blame. And you know what? That's fine by me. You know what? as I said before in other videos, you know, ultimately, I'm the uploader, I'm the one who's playing the game, so if the game goes poorly, it's because I fucked up. And I got nobody to blame but myself, because it ain't a multiplayer game, okay? It's not like I'm playing with three other people and, you know, it ain't like a dungeon in World of Warcraft where even if the rogue or the mage caused the wipe, you blame the priest or the tank because we wiped, it's your fault! Even if it was somebody else's fault for pulling all that mess when they shouldn't have. But now, you know, well, you didn't heal us enough. Well, you know, there's this thing, it's called mana, and if I don't have any, I can't do anything. I mean, that's the same thing for casters. No mana and no spells. It don't matter if you're a priest or a mage. No mana, no spells. Now, tanks, on the other hand, I never was a tank. Alright? I will get that out of the way real quick. I did play a warrior in World of Warcraft. But I went more for the DPS warrior talent trees than I ever did go for the tanking talent trees. I was more of, you know, the rogue in plate, you know? I haven't played WoW in years, you know. I fought the good fight with that game six years worth of on and off gameplay until finally I just, you know, just wasn't for me anymore. So, okay, I think I babbled enough at the end of this episode. Oh, just gonna do a quick stretch here and tell you that I've been the Lumberjack. I hope you've been you. As always, I've been asked that you behave yourselves. And since I'm the uploader, I'm first. And I will see you all next time.